Namaste. Welcome to Secrets of Yogic Science program. Actually, in our India, the science of yoga is the major portion of our ancient sciences. Our ancient time onwards, so many yogis, so many rishis, so many saints, they are performing their ultimate gaining by the yogic science. This is not only the religious base, this is actually science related base. But some people, they are anti of that yogic system, but some people agree to yogic system, whatever it may be. The right way is the right path of the human life, human eternal power, ultimate power, everything. The right path is only through passing in the yogic system only. This is the truth. Now we can see actually what is yogic science secrets, what is not only best, because so many videos available in the YouTube, asanas, pranayamas, these all the things available. So you are all are expert in that science. But now I want to relieve some of the secrets in yogic science by bless of our gurus. Now, what is yoga? First of all, the yoga means chitta vritti nirodhaka yoga. This is told by the great Patanjali in the Patanjali Yoga Sutras, in the Samadhipada second sutra. So the chitta vritti nirodhaka yoga. So here two works is there. One is what is chitta, we have to know. The second one is vritti nirodhaka. Vritti means way of working. Nirodhaka means completely stop, not only temporary stop, it's a permanent stop. So how to stop the vritti, that is one thing. The second thing is what is chitta. These two things we have to know. Before knowing these all the things, actually our body system, how to become our body, how to become our jiva. Jiva means inside the body, what is that power is there. This body is, it's either live body or dead body. But inside one thing is there, it's available inside the body, it's called as a live body. It's disappear from that body, it's called as a dead body. So the body is body, but what is inside that thing, that is also we have to know. How to it will become, what about the thing, these all the things, basic things we have to know. Now we go for that first thing. Body, external body. If you take example, this is the external body. This external body comes from the panchabhutas. Panchabhutas, you know, earth, water, fire, air, ether. These are the five is the panchabhutas. The earth, water. Water means not only our drinking water is not only belongs to the panchabhuta. It's a panchabhutamsa. It comes from the derived from the panchabhuta. That water is different, earth is different, ether is different, air is different, fire is different. This is actually panchabhuta is different. So we have to know that. That panchabhuta, this external, our physical body comes from which panchabhuta? That panchabhuta is the temporary panchabhuta, not permanently panchabhuta. It's a temporary only. This panchabhutas, that temporary panchabhutas is derived from the two things. One is microcosm, the second one is macrocosm, like stola and sokshma. These two things. That temporary panchabhutas derived from, comes from, produced by trigonas. Trigona means tamoguna, rajoguna, sattvaguna. These three gunas. These trigunas basically producing the temporary panchabhutas. Actually the trigunas also producing to the tridosas also. Tridosa means vata, pitta, kapha. Actually the whole human body nature, the whole total universe belongs to the tridosas only. The tridosa theory is the very, very important theory, very ultimate theory. This is only the truth theory. This is what I am telling, that is truth. It's not religious based, it's not any believing based. It's true. So the vata, pitta, kapha. These three dosas only belongs to human body. These three things belongs to our mental body. These three things belongs to our weather. These three things belongs to the universe. Everything is there, tridosas is there. The tridosas comes from the trigunas. The trigunas comes from omkara. Omkara means it's a universal sound. The omkara, it starts from the ether. Ether is the first primary panchabhuta. So that omkara is the it's a universal sound. That sound is has just some power. It's a in Telugu in Bible said it's a vakku. Vakku means it's a sound. It's a the ancient time before the universal making time, the omkara is available. The omkara is not only pranava, but so many people telling the omkara means pranava, pranava nada means omkara, but pranava nada is different, omkara is different. This what I am telling, that omkara is released to the trigunas, trigunas to temporary panchabhutas making the physical body. So after disappear our jiva, that our physical body, this external body become a dead body. If you leave that dead body, gradually that dead body will also disappear from all the panchabhutas. So this is a temporary thing. This is comes from the trigunas. Trigunas comes from the omkara. The omkaras also comes from the another panchabhuta. Another panchabhuta means omkara comes from which panchabhuta? That is the permanent panchabhuta. That is also earth is there, water is there, fire is there, air is there, ether is there. But that panchabhuta is the permanent panchabhuta. That panchabhuta is that is very, very important and ultimate eternal power. The universal power. What is that universal power? That is belongs to that panchabhutas. That panchabhuta is the permanent panchabhuta. That panchabhuta also comes from the pranava. Here pranava is very important. The pranava nada is releasing to the permanent panchabhutas. That panchabhutas no one can destroy. But the our physical body related to temporary panchabhutas we can destroy. But that permanent panchabhutas no one can destroy. Pranava released to the permanent panchabhutas. That pranava also comes from the jivanuvu. That is very, very important thing. In yoga, entire yoga science belongs to jivanuvu. Not these all the things what already we are telling some more information. That actual yoga science belongs to jivanuvu. Jivanuvu. The jivanuvu is the basic starting point of the our life. That is the release to the pranava. Pranava release to permanent panchabhutas. Permanent panchabhutas release to omkara. Omkara to trigunas. Trigunas to tridosas, microcosm and macrocosm. And it's released to the temporary panchabhutas. Temporary panchabhutas to physical body. That physical body enter to the starting point. Jivanuvu enter to the the jivanu enter to the our external body. Then it's run by using of the panchabhutas power. This is the actual thing. Actually trigunas released to already we are telling trigunas. The trigunas released to the microcosm means sukshma deha. Sukshma deha means microcosm. That microcosm released to, in that microcosm has actually four indriyas. Actually indriya is only one, but that one means you have become yogi. But that one is dividing to four types, that is called your normal person. You have to using a proper sadhana or proper disciplining life by doing a travel at the path of that yogic science. Then that four Indias become a one India. That now we see that names. The out of four Indias, first is mind, the second one is knowledge, third one is will, the fourth one is ego. That in Sanskrit names is mind means manas, knowledge means buddhi, means yukti, will means chitta, fourth one ego means ahankara. Here the third one will is means that chitta. That will, it's a continuously films is coming continuously, which means that thoughts flowing or different opinions, feelings, everything run by only chitta. But that chitta floating, you have to stop, then all four together only one. That is called chitta vritti nirodhaka yoga. It's a directly simplified things. Actually the in-depth knowledge is totally different, but our basic thing only we have to know that. But these thing already we are telling chitta vritti nirodhaka yoga. So that will way of working, you have to stop and stabilizing, then our willpower will increase. Because our will continually, the rhythm is continually, work of activities is running, obviously our will become a decrease, that power will decrease. It's a bending, but that will always in subordinate. How did subordinate means? That subordinate way is the only solution is stop that work of the willing. Then only the manas means mind, knowledge and ego, everything become a only one. That is called chitta vritti nirodhaka yoga. This is the basic thing of that yogic science, yogic system. How to do that? We have to meet that sadgurus and that yoga masters. Now the sadgurus or yoga masters means not only asanas or circus feats, that is not a yoga masters. That yoga master means this thing who will completed in their life, that is called the real sadgurus, the real gurus. Our ancient time the gurukulas only available and maintained by the great gurus. Gurus means masters. That masters who are actual masters are doing these all the things. In that yogic science, once we stop that chitta vritti, we have to know some more elaborated things. Now we can see only three types of systems. One is Naadi system, Chakra system, Breath system. These three systems now we can discuss. So in that Naadi system, we have to know first of all what is Naadi. Naadi means it's not one kind of external body point of view, it's a channel. It's inside body of that, some channels is there. That channel is called a Naadi. But external Naadi means in that channel traveling one particular energy or life force. That is called Naadi. So Naadi means not only that ways, that inside the traveling of that life force, which type of travelings is type of elaborated in our body, that is called Naadi. So this Naadi is basically as per Brozaitya Ratnakara, that is the classical books. Now I am telling some classical books names. Brozaitya Ratnakara is explained about 3,50,000 Naadis. Already in our YouTube channel, previous two videos is there. One is philosophy, the second one is the secret of breath in yogic system. These two videos are available in our channel. Then you can see that, then you can know more knowledge. So the Brojaitar Ratnakara textbook explains about the 3 crores 50,000 nadis. The next one, Samasamhita is 3,50,000 nadis. Prapancha Sara Tantra, that is also one kind of classical textbook, olden textbook. That textbook told the 3 lakhs nadis. Swara Chintamani, Sava Swarodayam, classical Atyoga books, and Garinda Samhita. These all the things explain about the 72,000 nadis. Actually, the all yogis and great masters, everyone knows about the 72,000 nadis, but 72,000 nadis also is a major nadis. Out of 72,000 nadis, in sub parts, sub little bit channels, everything will consider as a 3 crores 50 lakhs nadis. That is the Brojaitar Ratnakaram. Actually, in Telugu, one word is there. In Indian philosophical, Mukkoti Devata. Mukkoti means 3 crores. Actually, the 3 crores is available in our inside that body, not external from our body. It's not available in temples, seriously not available, but everything is, every goddess and every god and whatever it thing is belongs to in our body. Actually, every nadi is open, then only that related gods have some features. That features comes to me or comes to us, comes to you. How will that? We have to maintain that proper way of that nadis. That nadi vijnana is very, very important in the yogic science. But later we can explain that in depth. But now we can see that, yeah, what is that nadi and the nadi numbering. So 72,000 nadis is the very important nadis. We have to know these all the things. In the great Varma science, Varma Kalai, it's explained by the 18 Siddhas. The Siddhas release one classical textbook that is called Varma Olinul. Varma Olinul is the one of the classical textbook. In that Varma science explained the 72,000 nadis belongs to our body, which organs. Then first one is the head. The head is 7,000 nadis. Ear, 3,300 nadis. Eyes, 4,000 nadis. Nostril area, this is 3,380 nadis. Shoulder and neck, that is the 6,000 nadis. And throat area, 5,000 nadis. Our hands, 3,000 nadis. And shoulder and navel point, umbilicus. That navel point, our shoulder, between area, 10,170 nadis. And our back, it's 8,000 nadis. Fingers, 3,000 nadis. Our shoulder organs, it's 7,000 nadis. Anus, 5,000 nadis. Inside that anus, 2,000 nadis. Foot, 5,150 nadis. Actually, our sensible genital organs also there. That genital organs also 7,000 nadis. These all the things, the total is 72,000 nadis. So these 72,000 nadis available in our body. Actually, here some main nadis we have to know. The main nadis is generally Dasavidha nadis is there. It's a 10 nadis. Out of 72,000 nadis, we have to know that Dasavidha nadis. Dasavidha nadis means, Dasa means 10 nadis. One is Ida, Pingala, Susumna, Gandhari, Asti, Posala, Bhusita, Kohaka, Sankini, Sarada. These 10 nadis is the very, very important nadis in our body. Out of that 10 nadis also we have to know. The one is Vajra Nadi, Chitta Nadi, Brahma Nadi. These three is the main to the Yanda three nadis. The major nadi also there, that is called Datta Naadi. This is the total 14. The first 10 is the very important. The next 4 also very very important. But next 4, so many people they are siding. But mostly 10 Naadis only they are telling. Here, Ida, Pingala, Susumna. These 3 Naadis belongs to Vata. Next, Gandhari, Asti, Posala, Bhusita belongs to Pitta Dosa. And Kohaka, Sankini, Sarada. These 3 Naadis belongs to Kapha Dosa. Vajra Naadi, Chitta Naadi, Brahma Naadi. These 3 Naadis relates to the Susumna Naadi. Susumna Naadi also very very important Naadi. It's a master Naadi. It's a ultimate Naadi. But all are nowadays all are using the Susumna name, Susumna wording. But so many people how to open the Susumna they don't know. The Susumna how to enter that don't know. That is the limit. But Susumna is very very important. Before knowing the Susumna, we have to know Vajra Naadi, Chitta Naadi, Brahma Naadi. The 3 Naadis we have to know. You have to enter first of all. But whatever jiva, that is you. You have to enter these all the Naadis. Actually, out of 72,000 Naadis, actually is working. But some Naadis totally close. When are doing that sadhana in proper yogic system, then only that Naadis will open. Datta Naadi is the ultimate thing that is explained by the great yoga masters only explain about the Datta Naadi. Now I don't want to tell that. So the Chitta, Brahma was the, these 3 Naadis belongs to Susumna Naadi. And gentle organs area 7000 Naadis is there. That 7000 Naadis also very sensible Naadis, very sensitive Naadis. That Naadis also very important to the our body surveying as well as our doing yogic path also. That is the major portion by the gentle organ Naadis. So this is the little bit knowledge about the Naadi system. Now we can see about the chakra system. Actually, seriously, I don't know about the chakras. I know you know very well about the chakras in our human body, but I don't know. But what I know, that little bit thing I want to sharing with you. Actually, in chakra means it's the energy producing area, energy production area, that is called chakra. In simple wording is our energy cell is called as a chakra. The chakra is very important in yogic science and our ancient Varma science or Marma science, that thing also very important in the chakra system. In Varma Kale, so many diversifications is there, so many types is there. One of the types is Aadhar Varmam. Aadhar Varmam means it's related to the chakras. Actually, in total human body, more than 110 chakras is there. A small, big, large, everything is called as a 110 chakras, more than 110 chakras. Because the chakra means the energy flowing related area is chakra. Suppose example, compared to these two areas, this area is sensitive and more energy and more important area compared to this. So this is also one chakra. So that type of things in our human body, more than 110 chakras is there. Out of human body, out of external body also, out of our head also, some chakras is there. That is the secondary thing. We have to leave that. First of all, the main chakras is 7. 7 chakras: Mooladhara, Swadhisthana, Manipurika, Anatha, Visuddhi, Ajna, Sahasrana. These 7 chakras is very important. It's a Sapta chakras. Actually, here one thing is there, that human body and astral body, by inside that body and physical external body, these two things point of view, the related is the one bhuta. Actually, our external body belongs to 2 bhutas. Internal body belongs to 2 bhutas. These 2 bodies related is one bhuta. The total is panch bhutas, 5 bhutas. This is actual yogic science. But in this thing, we have to know about that. Out of 7 chakras, first five means Moladhara, Swadhisthana, Manipuraka, Anahata, Visuddhi. These five chakras, two ways is there. One kind of way, one kind of path belongs to front side. Front side means our external body. External physical body point of view, front side, five chakras is there. These five chakras belongs to Panchabhutas. Moladharas to Visuddhis, Panchabhutas, five chakras. This is one kind of way. Another way of the five chakras belongs to our backside. Backside means spine related. That spine related belongs to entire Naadi system and entire our internal jiva, internal body is what is that there? That is related to our backside chakras. That backside chakras totally related to Sushumna Naadi. At the same time, that seven chakras belongs to that internal way. First five chakras, one kind of way is belongs to physical body. That is called Panchabhutas. So first five chakras belongs to front side external body. That first five chakras, the internal power related to our internal body. That is also backside also available. At the same time, remaining two, Ajna chakra and Sahasrara chakra also belongs to our internal body. This is the hidden truth of the chakra system. So now we can see that this out of these seven chakras, actually some other main chakras also there. Out of more than the seven, some important chakras also there. The great Goraknath. Goraknath means out of Navanadas. The Goraknath is the second Nath. The Goraknath is very very important truth relieving by his book. That book name is Siddha Siddhanta Sangraha. That book name is Siddha Siddhanta Sangraha. In that book he explained 10 chakras. Mooladhara, Swadhisthana, Manipura, Anahata, Visuddhi, Ajna, Sahasrara. These seven is accepted and other three also explained. That is called Surya Chakra, Manaha Chakra and Brahma Gohara Chakra. That is very very important thing. Actually the first five chakras, first five out of seven, first five chakras belongs to Antar Kumbhaka and Prana Spandana. But the total seven chakras belongs to Prana Kumbhaka and Kundalini related. That Kumbhaka is very very important science. Now later we can see that Kumbhaka is Bahya Kumbhaka. So many people Rachaka, Poraka, Kumbhaka. You see, exhaling that breath, inhaling that breath and stop that breath. That is called, this is Kumbhaka, so many people telling. But Kumbhaka is so many types. This is the Bahya Kumbhaka. This is Antar Kumbhaka. This is very very important. And Bahya Abhyantar Kumbhaka. This is related to here. And Kaval Kumbhaka. And Sahaja Kumbhaka. Kumbhaka is so many types is there. Later we can see that about Kumbhakas. But the external body point of view, first five chakras belongs to Antar Kumbhaka, not Bahya Kumbhaka. Antar Kumbhaka and Prana Spandana. We have to know that Prana Spandana. Prana means life force. That our total seven chakras belongs to our astral body. At the same time, that is belongs to Prana Kumbhaka and Kundalini. These things we have to implement in our yogic path, then only activate to the chakras. So many books available in the market, so many people telling this is chakra, this is figure is there, that is triangle figure, rectangle figure, this figure, this color, that color, this is base axis, that base axis. We can see that chanting, nothing, because if you chanting, your mind will become a some stimulating, then you can some manovikasa. Manovikasa means your mind structural point of view, your mind thoughts flowing point of view, some differences maybe you will get. Then compared to your previous life, now this life is maybe some changing is there, but that thing is only. But actually the chakras is totally, the science is different. The Kundalini is totally different. The Kumbhakas is totally different. If you see all the things, the Panchabhutas controlling in our head. But Panchabhutas controlling means in our cereals is there. Like you can chanting one goddess or one god, then that Panchabhuta will come. That is totally stories. That stories you can avoid. But real truth is very important. This is science. This is real pathway. You have to know these all the things. If you clear all the your Naadi, total Naadi stimulating system, you clear all chakra system, then only you will get control the Panchabhutas. If you control the Panchabhutas, then you can know what is pranava. If you know that pranava, then you can seeing actual your face. Not this is not my face, because sometimes is like in this birth this is my face, but what about before birth? What is that face? After that, this is that body. Then what is actually my face? That is you have to know that. That is very very important. So this is the open view of that chakras. In that chakras, in Gorakhnath telling in the chakras, Surya chakra, Mana chakra, and Brahma Kohar chakra. In the chakras also there, Chandra chakra also there. So many chakras is there, but stop. But Brahma Kohar chakra, that is very very important. That Brahma Kohara chakra belongs to above that epiglottis. So that is very very important. Here we can see, we can know something about that our breath system also. Then we can clearly understand about these all the things. Now we can see about the breath system. Already we little bit know about Naadi system. Little bit know about chakra system. Now you can see that breath system. This is very very important. This is the final system. This is very important because our already in our channel one video is available, that is called breath system in the secret of breath in yogic system. That is the title. In our channel is available. Then you can see that. Then you can understand what is that breath very important in the yogic system. What about that breath? What about exhaling, inhaling, healing? These all the things you have to know. Now we can go for breath system. Breath related to air. Air means vayu. This is one of the major panchabhuta. Now we can see the types of vayus. Dasavidha vayus. Ten types of vayus. 10 types of air is in our body. The first one is apana, samana, prana, udana, vyana. These 5 is the major panchavayus. Pancha means 5, major panchavayus. Another 5 vayus also there. It's a sub-vayus. That is called Devadatta, Naga, Krukura, Korma, Dhanunjaya. Dhanunjaya vayu is the very very important vayu. It's a Varma science also explained about lot of things in the by for the Dhanunjaya vayu. And Siddhas also explained lot of things in Dhanunjaya vayu and Pran vayu. Dhanunjaya vayu is very very important. Dhanunjaya vayu related to our life force. So that is okay. That is second thing. Now this is the Dasavidha vayu, 10 vayus. These 10 vayus names you are also very knows very well. 18 Siddhas told another 4 vayus also there. Total 14 vayus. The another 4 vayus, these names belongs to Tamil system, because this is the told by the Siddhas. So this is the old Tamil language. That is Vairavan, Mukhyavan, Antaryami, Pravajan. These 5. This is 4 is the another vayus. The total is 14 vayus. Actually, that in our human body, total 49 vayus is there. 49 vayus is there. 49 types of that AC is in our body. 49. So we can know the first 14. Remaining things, once we start the yogic science pathway in our life, we have to travel that path of the yogic system. Then we can know remaining all the vayus. The 49 also you have to know. In the now you can see that trimandalas. Trimandala means three types of mandalas. Three types dividing is in our human body. That is called Chandramandala, Suryamandala, Agnimandala. These three is the very, very important. And three grandis also there. Grandi means it's not only we can explain about to the modern terminology. Grandi means gland actually. But that human glands is different, endocrine system, glands. That glands is different. Now we can tell three grandis. One is Brahma Grandi, Vishnu Grandi, Rudra Grandi. These three grandis. Now we can see that three mandalas. Chandra Mandala, Surya Mandala, Agni Mandala. Out of seven chakras, Sahasrana and Ajna Chakra, these two things is belongs to Chandra Mandala. Visuddhi, Anahata, Manipuraka. These three chakras belongs to Surya Mandala. Swadhisthana and Mooladhara. These two chakras belongs to Agni Mandala. This is the thing. Actually, our breath point of view, generally our breath, just you can see. It's inhaling, that is fulfilled to the lungs. Then lungs will elaborate and you know that anatomy. So heart pumps to that blood, it's oxidated blood is making, then from lungs to heart and heart circulates the all over the body. Actually here one main thing is there. Our Naadi system, Ida Pingala, we have to know already. Here Ida Pingala is that is totally different science, that is very depth science, is a Surya Yoga point of view. Here I can't explain all the things. Actually our breath point of view, two nostril ways is there. One is right, the second one is left. Right nostril point of view directly linked with lungs. Left nostril point way is more than 50% way is belongs to top area. Is it possible? That is true. Because this is called as Antarkumbhaka. Antarkumbhaka means, actually Kumbhaka means other meaning is there. That is we don't know. But actually the general terminology is Kumbhaka means our air become a comes to one organ. That organ area, the total air belongs to stabling. That is called Kumbhaka in general meaning. It's a general meaning of Kumbhaka, not meaning actual definition of Kumbhaka is not like that. So this is the way. So our left nostril, most of the air goes to our brain. But so many people, they don't know this thing, but this is true. So our breath sent to inside that head. So that is very, very important. That is called Vasi Yogam, and that is Siddha Yogam, and so many names is there. Some people follow some people follow some names like that. This is called Shakti Yogam. And the right side nostril waves goes to within lungs area, that is called Shiva Yoga. And Shiva Shakti Yoga also there. Actually the Shiva Shakti is concept is like that. That our breath is goes to brain, that is Shakti Yoga. Our breath goes to in lungs, that is Shiva Yoga. Shiva Yoga belongs to physical body. Shakti Yoga belongs to our astral body, like our mental body. This is the Shiva Shakti concept. This is the Prakriti Purushudu concept. This is man and woman concept. Actually our intercourse means sexual game. Actually sexual game is not like that. We know sex, but that is not actual sex. This is the actual sex. So one time you can control our physical body and mental body also. Our total system is breath goes to in mind directly, and another way of that breath goes to in directly in lungs way. These two things doing at a time. This is the actual yogic science. This is the actual basic of pranayama. Actually pranayama means not like that. But that is a breathing exercise. Breathing exercise is different, pranayama is different. Pranayama means if you tell I am doing pranayama means you are doing using by prana, not by the breath, not by the air. Air is not prana. Prana is different, air is different. Air change to the prana, how to change the prana. That is also you have to know. These are all the things we have to know by the blessing of great gurus. So here our breath sent to upside. That is called antarkumbhaka. It's here you have to stay your entire breath. You have to stay here only. But this totally belongs to the way of Brahma Kuhara Chakra. This is explained by the Goraknath. Already we told that Brahma Kuhara Chakra is belongs to upon that epiglottis. But that is very very important. Here one thing is there. Amsa Paramahamsa. We have to know these two names. Paramahamsa means breathing. Our breath enter through the Brahma Kuhara Chakra, you will become a Amsa. Through that Brahma Kuhara Chakra, if you enter in Sushumna Nadi, that is called, you are considered as a Paramahamsa. In Brahma Kuhara to Sushumna Nadi traveling point of view, you will become a Brahmasri. This is the actual titles. In olden days, this titles belongs to dead persons only. But nowadays, in Kali Yuga, so many people, they are become a Brahmasis, they are become a Amsas, they are become a Paramahamsas like that. Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, he knows how to his channel enter in the Sushumna. So he is a Paramahamsa. So that is very important. Your breath going upon that epiglottis, that Brahma Kuhara Chakra is there. It's not Ajna Chakra. It's Ajna Chakra, Sahasrana Chakra between Brahma Kuhara Chakra is there. That Brahma Kuhara Chakra is very very important. If you enter in the Brahma Kuhara Chakra, that is you are become a Amsa. That is challenging. You are that is the ultimate power. From where is there? From Brahma Kuhara Chakra to Sushumna. Then this Amsa enter to the Sushumna. That is called as a Prana, life force. That is actually Prana. That is Prana Shakti. That is ultimate power. That is called as a Paramahamsa. That is actual titles. This is the breathe system. So Nadi system, breathe system, and chakra system. These all the chakras and nadis and breathe, these all the things we know little bit knowledge. Now we can see that actually how to change that breathe system. Now we can see that. This is the right nostril, this is the left nostril. Right nostril called as a, this is the way to the Pingala Nadi. This is way to the Ida Nadi. But so many people, this is Ida Nadi, this is Pingala Nadi. This is not a nadis, it's a holes. It's a holes only, not a nadis. So this is way of Pingala Nadi, this is way of Ida Nadi. So actually that Ida Nadi start from the right toy. Pingala Nadi start from the left toy. To here, every chakra, already we told 7 chakras. So first, these 6 chakras totally link with. So that chakras is going like that. To chakras touching to, the nadis will travel like that. Already we saw that image in this video. Now we can see that Ida Asanam, Pingala Asanam, Chandra Kala Asanam, Surya Kala Asanam. These asanas is very important for changing that breath. This is Yogadanda. This is not a doll. It's a Yogadanda. It's not a toy. Remember that. So, if you touch like that, it's a left hand. So, our breath changes to right side. If you like, keep like that, our breath right to left. So that total breath related things you can see our previous videos, then you can understand. It's a secret of breath in yogic system. That is the title of that video, then you can see that. So this is like that. So this is upside, this is downside. Up to down is a travel to the air. So right nostril to left nostril it's converted, and the same thing also like this. This is one way. Now you can see that immediately change within 1 second, within 2 seconds, change that breath immediately. Then now you can see that. Now we can see first of all Chandra Asana or Ida Asana. that Ida Asana means, first we can see that this is the left leg. Ida Naadi starts from the right toe to travel right leg from here to like that. Okay, understand? Okay, this is my right leg. This is right leg toy. From Ida Naadi starts from here. So this is the left leg. So the Ida Naadi starts from this way totally like that. This way. So you are using the left leg touch here. Okay. Then that Naadi is at turning to comes from left side. So this area means here, this area. You can see this area, then you can touch. So many ancient yogis doing their sadhana is like this. So this is Ida Asana or Chandra Asana. So this is like that. So this touching is above the genital organ. That is very, very important. Here urinary bladder is there. If you touch this bladder, this is good for prostatitis and this is good for urinary infection, urinary bladder infection, and this is good for kidney also. So it's a physical advantages, but now I'm telling that breathing point of view. So this is. So if you do within 2-3 seconds, our right side free of air comes from left side, immediately converted. So this is the cooling to the body. If you heat in your body, then you can do this asana, your body will become a cool, because this side of that air flowing gives the cooling, this side, right side, air flowing gives to the heat to the body. So this is the cooling. Okay, so this is the Ida Asana. Now if anyone have some problem is there, some liberalization in the asana, is called as a Chandra Kalasana. Chandra Kalasana means like that. So this is beside the genital organ. The first one is above the genital organ. Okay, so this is the Chandra Kalasana. Now we can see opposite asana, that is called Pingala Asana or Surya Asana, Surya Kalasana. These two things we can see. The same thing we can do in reverse. So Pingala Naadi starts from left leg toy. Okay, this is traveling like that. Here to cutting way. Not so many images like that. Ida Naadi and Pingala Naadi, not like that. It's a traveling. It's like that. So that is the thing. Now you can see that Pingala Naadi is in this leg. Left leg is Pingala Naadi. So you can touch. Can touch, then this is my genital organ. Above that genital organ, I keep it. This is Pingala Asana, Surya Asana. This is Pingala Asana. So this is in ancient, so many rishis, their photos is like that, because that is the secret. So many people telling this is the Ardha Padmasana. It's not Ardha Padmasana. It's different. Lotus position, other half lotus position is different. This is the Pingala Asana. Now you can, beside that gentle organ, that is called Surya Kalasana. In this doing asana, your breathing going to right nostril. This asana you will give to the heat to your body. Heat. In winter season, if you doing this asana, obviously your sweat will release within 5 minutes. Then you can try this. So this is. But this asana is not only puppet show. This is very important asanas. So these asanas you have to do under your yoga masters. That is very, very important. Without knowing knowledge, only sitting in front of YouTube, you don't perform. That is very, very important. You have to remember that. So this is the thing. This is Surya Kala Asana. This is Surya Asana or Pingala Asana. This is the thing. Now this is the thing. Now some of my friends and well-wishers asked me, they have their spinal or some problem is there. In that spinal point of view, they are become a, their spine very weak by using useless food. Then if they want to doing meditation, then they feel some pain is backside. So that's why what we'll do. Now I want to that remedy. It's a jhana virasana. Jhana virasana. You remember jhana virasana. I know I think you are all know about the jhana virasana. That jhana virasana, if you performing, is good for your waist area and your spine area, mostly in lumbar region area. Then you can sit more time in the meditation in jhana virasana. Jhana virasana, anyone can do that. In this jhana virasana, you can change first of all vajrasana position. From vajrasana to you can do that jhana virasana. Now I can convert it as a vajrasana my body. Vajrasana. This is vajrasana. Now you can from one knee to end of knee like this. That is called jhana virasana. So you can see that. So leg position is very very important. This is good for your waist area and your lumbar region area. Then you can sit properly here. So many minutes in that meditation position. So you have any lumbar region problem, then you can choose this type of asana for doing your sadhana. So this is the jhana virasana. So here one main condition is the knees exactly this position only. One knee under the other knee like this. This is you can sit in proper way, free way. This is the jhana virasana. Now in yoga science, the main thing is the catching our life force, means prana shakti, prana. So in that prana also related to one asana is there. So many people asked me, sir, any prana asana is there? Then I will tell that no. So this prana asana is not related to actual yogic science secrets. So just I want to explain about the prana asana, prana related. So if you do the prana asana, obviously your health will become a good. So that's why I'm telling prana asana now. The prana asana means first of all this is right leg. Keep it in left hip joint. Then you can like that. This is left leg. This is right leg. This is left hand. So left hand like that. This is pranasana. The same as well as you can do reverse also. The same reverse like that. This is right leg. This is right hand. You can see that body will spine will straight. Okay, this is pranasana. But our nostril breathe point of view, idasana, pingalasana, this is very very important. The next one is siddhasana. And Padmasana very very important, you know that all the asanas. So in that all the asanas, so many asanas available in lot of YouTube videos. Then you can see that first of all you can search the right Sadguru. Then only your birth totally fulfilled. Namaste.